Hey, what's going on, guys? We're back where we started, with the class trial. I think this is where it's headed.
Alrighty, guys! It's finally time! That's right! It's time for the long-awaited class trial!
I'm down, dude. Let's go.
Now then, I shall tell you all the meeting place. At the central island of Jabberwock Island, there is a mountain with my adorable face.
I know.
My friends, please proceed to the underground by taking the elevator located at the secret entrance.
Got it.
I'll see you.
Mountain car at the central. I know, I've seen it. I know where it is. Oh, cool. It puts me right here. That's awesome. Wait, isn't it? I'm gonna say it's over here. I've possibly taken the exact wrong way to get there. But I'm pretty sure it's left. This is where the park entrance is, right? Okay, it was right. Gosh darn it. That's fine. We'll just get more experience. We're level 17, which is cool. We should probably check our pet, just in case. Probably needs cleaning. I don't check it enough. Despair meter? Oh, but you need more hope. You need more hope. More hope is needed. Look at that lighthouse, though. Really low-res height lighthouse, actually. I feel like I could make a better lighthouse. I don't know. Maybe, I don't know. I don't know what this engine is. Okay. What's this? What do we got? Monokuma Rock. What the heck is that mountain? When did that? It was there the entire time. How did they even make a mountain with shaped like Monokuma?
No way.
That story might be true after all. There might be an enormous organization involved in all this. You mean what Byakuya said
you
all?
You are right.
Byakuya, we still needed his knowledge. That's why he's dead though. Is because the killer's smart. Byakuya. What happened to Gundam and Fubiko? Oh, you mentioned it. It appears they aren't here yet.
I got it!
I know, they probably ran away.
No way!
There's no way I'd let them escape, you know? Look, I dragged this one back over here.
Don't fuck with me!
I'm telling you, let me go!
Hey!
If you keep acting violent, I just might eat you up.
Hey,
Fubiko, what were you doing all this time?
Huh?
Nothing. I wasn't really doing anything. I was chilling in my room when I suddenly heard the fat bastard got killed. Yeah, who the fuck cares about that anyway?
You.
How can you say something so irresponsible?
Do you understand?
We've been doing our best to investigate this murder, and even though we don't want to, just to survive.
Wait!
Mahiro, that's enough. You too, Fujiko. Dumbass. Thanks for waiting for Gundam.
What happened?
I am right here.
Now then,
and remember this well. A main character arrives when he intends to. Stop. Huh?
Hey.
Seems you noticed it too. If he did, then I'm right.
Well, man.
Let's take the secret entrance to the trial field.
Wait
a second.
What's this?
Oh my, Monami. What are you doing here? Nobody asked for you.
I.
You actually want to join in?
You
want to taste how powerless you are at the class trial? You're an even bigger masochist than I thought.
Special
oh well,
service.
I'm a big brother who dotes on his little sister. I shall allow your special participation.
See ya later!
I'll go on ahead and wait for you guys. So hurry over.
Huh?
He told us to come, but how did we get there? I don't see any doors or vehicles.
What's going on?
You mentioned something about a secret entrance, was it? Secret entrance. Roar. Something shakes. This is dangerous. Everyone get down. An escalator just flies out of the mouth.
What?
Another suspicious aura. Even I, the Crimson Steel Mega Elephant, is troubling with it. That's totally suspicious.
Hey,
forgive me.
Hey.
Just forgive me already. Why don't we just stop here? I mean, none of this is real anyway. Not even remotely.
No way.
There's just no way we'll find the killer.
Stupid!
Complaining won't get us anywhere. If you're really a man, then man up for God's sake. We've come this far. We have no choice but to keep moving forward. You're right. There's nowhere for us to run. We need to do it. If that's everyone's decision, I guess I'll just follow you guys. If this were a video game, it'd have to be a very high... It'd have a very high difficulty level. So let's do our best to clear the game. Dons. Shaking with fear and nervousness, I hesitantly lifted my feet and stepped onto the escalator. I won't think anymore. If I think, I'll run away. All I could do was stare upward intensely as the escalator carried me. And when each of us entered Monokuma Rock... Huh? This is an elevator. I see, the entire rock is an elevator. Once again, Monokuma is doing what he pleases. However, if he's gone this far to make something like this, I don't think he's playing around. Even so, we're going pretty deep. You're right. I heard an unnerving chattering sound inside my head. I soon realized it was the sound of my teeth. All I could do was... I like the imagery in this freaking thing. All that I had on my lips, so I couldn't hear anyone. Okay, let's go. I know it's Nagito. I'm gonna go out on a limb and say it's Nagito because he set up everything. There we were, listening to unpleasant roars as the elevator plunged deeper and deeper into the earth. Some time passed before the elevator finally finished descending, and then the elevator slowly opened.
Welcome!
Okay, welcome. This is the class trial field. How do you like it? It's a special place, or place where you decide your fates.
Why, you?
What the hell is he thinking, locking us in a shitty looking place like this?
Don't fuck with me!
Are you fucking crazy? Don't mess with me, asshole. Complain all you like. I'm used to it by now. You're wasting your time and energy. Hurry up and take your seats where your names are written. It looks like everyone knows, even if we try to resist, it won't change a thing. Just as Monokuma ordered, we walked towards the seats that we had been assigned. From this point on, we need to find out who killed Byaki. This might be a long, long episode, because we gotta go through this trash straw. The ultimate affluent progne, Byakuya Togomi. He was overly critical, arrogant, and condescending. But he also had a strong sense of responsibility. As we were panicking, he accepted his role as the leader and tried his very best to keep us together. A guy like him got murdered. The person who did it is one of us? I can't believe it. There's no way I can believe it. But if it's really true, we need to find out by any means possible. Because that's our only option. There's no way for us to survive unless we sacrifice the killer. Bring it. And so, this light-threatening trial billowing with hope and despair has begun. Let's go. Yes. Yes, I would. Yes, I would. I'll be back here coming again. The blue hue of our vacation is now crimson red. Is he really the killer or is it someone else? The class trial starts now. Okay, let's look at our truth bullets. Okay, so... let's look at the autopsy. A thin, sharp weapon around 5 millimeters in diameter. Let's look at the knife. That's something that is bothering me. Paint. Why? Who has paint? And why would it be glowing? Who has access to paint? I can only think Nagito because he's the one that was cleaning everything. A lot of blood was spattered. Also, there was no sign the body was dragged through the bloodstain. Okay, so he wasn't dragged. He was just under there, which makes no sense to me. I guess we're just gonna go. Let's do it. Class trial, start.
Now, Ben, let's begin with a simple explanation of the class trial. During the class trial, you will present your arguments for who the killer is and vote for who done it.
Look at him smiling over there. What the fuck are you doing, dude? I don't know.
If you vote correctly, then only the blackened will receive punishment. But if you pick the wrong person, I'll punish everyone besides the blackened, and that person will earn the right to leave this island.
Such a cruel rule.
Oh, jeez. Okay.
Before we begin, I'd like to confirm one thing. Is there really a killer among us?
Most definitely. There's no doubt that the blackened is lurking among you.
Okay.
Such a sad state of affairs, isn't it? By the way, this class trial is gonna be 100% fair, so there's no need to worry. I'm the type who hates favoritism and prejudice. Well, not as much as I hate Monami, of course.
You hate me that much?
Now, let's begin.
You're telling us to begin, but what are we supposed to do?
I don't think that she. I think she's completely out of the question. If we eliminate who we think that it's not.
No complaining. Let's just settle this with our fists.
So I don't think it's her. I think she's too stupid to understand anything, and she's too violent. I honestly don't think it's her. She's not as precise. She doesn't stab. She would, like, beat someone up.
Were you even listening to the rules?
It could be him, but he's in the back of my mind. Paint.
Didn't that Byakuya bastard get killed in the dining hall, huh? Then everyone there is a fucking suspect.
I don't think it's him.
Yeah. What you're really trying to say is that you're not the killer, right?
And I don't think it's her.
No shit. You guys went off on your own and started killing each other. This has nothing to do with me.
Huh? What does that mean?
Anyway, why don't we try talking about the most pressing issue on our minds?
I think it's you. Look at you and your smug face.
The most pressing issue on our minds? Where we found the body. It's very strange to find a body underneath the table.
Then, let's start with that mystery.
Very strange to find... Yeah, let's start with that mystery. The reason why Byakuya's body was discovered under the table in the dining hall table. We can start with that, but ultimately, we need to find out who murdered him. If we can't do that... No. Thinking about it as if is a waste of time. We have to do this no matter what. So the class trial has finally started. From this point on, I will provide simple tutorials at every important moment. I'm sorry, but please excuse my ear-tainting rudeness. As things progress, each class trial, you will engage in a number of non-stop debates. During these discussions, all of your classmates will speak one after the other without any breaks. It's up to you to reveal any lies or mistakes contained within their statements. This means you'll have to use truth bullets to refute what they say. Out of all the truth bullets you find during the investigation, only the relevant ones will be loaded into the truth cylinder. Use the mouse to move the reticle, then fire with the left mouse button. Pay close attention to each character's statements and choose your truth bullets to blast the right ones. Okay. I hope this isn't hard. If you run out of time, you'll automatically fail, so please be careful. Oh, fuck me, dude. Okay. Let's think about this. Peko's sick. Kazuichi was in the room, but he was talking the entire time, so it couldn't have been him. If we look at the kitchen guy was in the kitchen, and his alibi is that he came into the thing. Sonya Nevermind was in the room with us, but there's no suspicion on her, which is weird to me. If we look at that guy, I think he's too stupid. The buff guy, I think he's too stupid to commit a crime. I don't know. I can't rule anybody out right now. Gamer girl was outside, so it can't be her. I don't think it's the musician. If you press the escape key during the arguments, you can view the controls. Well then, good luck and have fun. Alright, let's go. Let's do it. Make your argument. Knife, blood stain on the table.
Why was Byakuya's body in a place like that?
Hold on. I just need to pause it. I'm freaking out. Okay. So why was Byakuya's body in a place like that?
His body was underneath the table.
His body was underneath the table.
At the very back of the dining.
The very back of the dining hall.
After the killer murdered Byakuya, they probably moved the body there.
Wait. No, no, no.
Huh? Why? Obviously by hiding the body. They tried to delay its discovery! Like a dog burying a bone!
Wait. It clearly contradicts the information I know. Yeah.
Why was Byaku... They probably moved the body there! No, that's wrong!
There we go.
I don't think the killer moved the body.
Thank you.
Try to remember what the body looked like when we found it under the table. Though there was a lot of blood everywhere, there was no sign the killer actually dragged the body through it.
Okay.
So that's why you think it's impossible that the killer moved the body. I see. I get your point.
Yeah.
Oh, and here I thought I had a genius idea.
Okay. Yeah.
Too bad you're so stupid and boring and unpopular. Your life is meaningless.
I respond better to praise, you know.
But if the killer didn't move the body,
then why
was it under the table?
I agree.
Byakuya was probably killed under the table.
There was duct
tape. You think he was killed under the table?
So Byakuya snuck under the table for reasons unknown.
Yeah.
And that's when he was killed. Then,
shortly thereafter, we found his body under the table.
That does make sense, but why did he go under the table?
It's a good question.
Obviously, he was hiding so he could surprise us. That dude was always a big jokester.
Dude, that's 100% lie.
The hell he was? You seriously couldn't tell what kind of person he was? Maybe he panicked during the blackout and dove under the table.
That's not true.
It's a blackout, not an earthquake. Just because the power went out doesn't mean he dive under the table.
I agree.
The reason why is probably connected to what Byakuya was doing during the party, don't you think?
You're leading this conversation, but I think it's you. The reason Byakuya dove under the table, if it's connected to what Byakuya was doing during the party, then it's probably... I have to... Freaking what? Where is she? Ibuki's account. But I think that's wrong. Flip. The reason why Byakuya dove under the table. Why did he dive under the table? If it's connected to what Byakuya was doing during the party, then it's probably... The knife? Is it the knife?
I can prove it with this!
Because there was a knife.
It probably has something to do with the knife we found under the table.
Yeah.
Knife? Oh!
Because he was...
You mean that thing that obviously screams, I am the murder weapon!
But it's not.
Byakuya probably noticed the knife was hidden there. So in order to get it...
That's right!
particularly sensitive to the presence of dangerous items, so I cannot deny. But how did he notice that there was a knife under the table?
It's true. It was pitch black.
If he knew beforehand, he probably would have done something about it before the blackout, right?
But there was green paint on it.
Then, instead of knowing about it beforehand, maybe he saw it right at that moment. Like, for example, he might have seen someone trying to take the knife out from under the table.
No, that's not possible.
What? You seem rather confident about that.
Of course. I have proof to back me up.
What is your proof?
This is almost like a real trial!
During the previous statement, there was only one weak spot. But from this point on, there will be various weak spots during In Your Way. No matter how many weak spots there are, there will be only one lie or contradiction in the debate at that time. This means there will be false weak spots. If you shoot a weak spot with the truth bullet, not only will you fail to refute what was said, but you'll also lower your trust with everyone and your influence gauge will take damage. If your influence gauge reaches zero, you will fail, so be extra careful. Gosh darn, this game is gonna kill me, dude. You have to rely on your own logic to determine where the weak spots actually are, lies, or mistakes. Also, if you concentrate by holding down the space key, you can progress the argument slowly. Please use it whenever you feel like the statements are moving too fast for you to aim. However, this does consume the focus gauge, so please be careful. You press the escape key, you can view the controls. Pressing the escape key is I think, my go-to. You can cheat the game a little bit, right? Knife, bloodstain under the table, gaps in the foreground, too tiny, night vision goggles. Jesus Lord, there's so much. Okay, I'm ready.
I'm sure Byakuya ducked under the table during the blackout.
Yeah, I also agree.
That sounds correct.
Yes.
If that's the case.
Yeah.
During the blackout, Mr. Ham Hands.
Sure.
Must have seen the killer take the knife.
Okay.
But it was super pitch black. It was so dark I couldn't see my food.
Okay. Byakuya couldn't.
That's wrong.
I doubt he could have seen the killer.
Rewind. Can I rewind?
I'm sure Byakuya ducked under the table.
Yeah, okay. Flip me, dude.
During the blackout.
Okay, so I have 5 minutes
that
to complete everything.
Correct.
That's correct. He did dive under the table. I just gotta get my bullets out fast enough.
During the blackout, Mr. Ham Hands must have seen the killer take the knife.
It's true.
But it was super pitch black.
Yeah.
It was so dark I couldn't see my food.
Byakuya couldn't see in the dark either.
No, that's wrong!
You got night vision goggles, beach.
No, Byakuya was probably the only one who was able to see in the dark.
Why do you say that?
He was using those night vision goggles we found under the table. He could have seen what was happening.
So, are you saying Byakuya was the one who used those night vision goggles?
Yes.
Yeah. Seems to be the case.
Your reasoning is out of focus.
Why?
No, that's obviously wrong. It should be the other way around.
Other way around?
Seriously? The killer used those night vision goggles, not Byakuya.
Were you surprised by Mahi? Yeah, kinda. Just between you and me, I was also surprised. Tutorial person. It is not good when you are also surprised. Just kidding, I'm sorry. Good, thank you. Now then, when this kind of argument suffices, you will go into a one-on-one debate called the Rebuttal Showdown. In this mode, you have to counter the other person's claim and draw out the weak spots and argue against them. Please counter the other person's remark with the WASD keys. Jesus, based on the shape of their remarks, it's important to know whether to cut... What? Cut vertically, sideways, or diagonally. Based on that, you can skew a debate's mood to your advantage. On the other hand, if you ignore the person's remarks, it will skew towards their advantage. In the bottom right corner of your screen, a number that shows the sharpness of your counter is displayed. This is the number of times you can cut remarks during one round of the debate. You will lose sharpness even if you miss, so please be careful. When the mood skews to your advantage for a certain length of time, the other party's argument changes. This means the conversation will develop, and if that happens, they will end up divulging some weak spots. However, you cannot normally cut remarks that contain weak spots. Instead, it will skew the mood toward the other party's advantage. Plus, it's going to be very big. Just like a regular debate, please refute any weak spots with the left mouse button. Of course, if you don't have the correct truth blade, you will not be able to cut an opponent's remark. What's a truth blade? Terribly sorry, it appears there's been a delay. Make sure the person in charge of contacting you takes a very long vacation. In this mode, truth bullets will be called truth blades. That's about it. There won't be any other changes to your handbook menu. Only the name was changed. But don't you think a change in feeling is important? If you press the escape key, you can view the controls. Well then, good luck and have fun. This is stupidly scary. Rebuttal showdown. Let's freaking go. Knife Durum in case, irons in the store. Knife Durum in case, irons in the storage room. Knife.
If you just use common sense. The killer obviously used those night vision goggles. That's gotta be it.
Okay. I should let Mara then find a point that I can argue against.
If you just use common sense. The killer obviously used those night vision goggles. That's gotta be it.
I can't back down.
What the flip? What?
Use night vision goggles, then they could have killed Byakuya even in the dream. In reality, so those goggles were planned in advance. The killer brought them to the crime scene.
Use.
Allow me to cut through those words.
Oh, thank God. Allow me to cut through those words. So cheesy.
No, Byakuya was definitely the one who brought those night vision goggles.
Definitely? But why?
Inside the Duralumin case Byakuya had with him during... We found a smaller case for storing the night
vision. Thank you, Lord.
Which means we can assume that the night vision goggles were kept inside that Duralumin case as well.
Duralumin.
Woohoo! I said assume! Ibuki never uses such clever
language.
Dude,
this is going to be such a long episode.
Plus, Byakuya was the only one who could have taken the night vision goggles out of the case.
Yeah, I agree.
Since he was carrying it around before the blackout in the first place.
I see. When you put it like that, it makes sense.
Then, was that knife
inside the case? Dude, this debating stuff is hard. It's a little bit like mini game-ish.
If there were night vision goggles inside, it wouldn't be weird for a knife to be in there too.
It would be weird.
I am weird, aren't I? At times like this, I'd rather be fantasizing about tonight's main dish.
Ew! You totally mean that in a perverted way.
The knife was brought in the Drummond case along with night vision goggles too. No, that's not possible. The knife was hidden in the dining hall before the party even started. I should be able to prove it. The knife was hidden in... Oh, do not... Duct tape.
I see!
Duct tape. It was duct taped.
There was duct tape left under the table where the body was found. Huh? Duct tape? They probably hit the knife by duct taping it to the underside of the table.
Yeah. You know who's not talking anymore? Nagito.
Though Byakuya was thorough, even he couldn't have noticed a weapon taped to the underside of the table.
This may be off topic, but why was Byakuya acting so paranoid?
Hey.
Not only did he bring a self-defense kit,
but I have a note.
But he had night vision goggles inside the case too.
That's true. He went above and beyond being a little cautious.
Now that you mention it, that applies to the dangerous items he confiscated as well. It's one thing to be a little cautious, but performing a body check is a bit much.
He probably knew someone was planning to commit a murder.
Are you saying he predicted the murder? Could it be? Was he also in possession of the all-seeing eye?
This guy.
You think so too, right, Hajime?
Yeah. That's right, Byakuya probably knew there was a possibility. And I know what it is. It's towards the end.
prove it with this. Everyone, can you please take a look at this?
Be careful, the first kill will happen tonight. Someone will definitely kill someone.
Hey, the hell is this? Hajime and I found this in Byakuya's cottage. It looks like a threatening letter someone sent for him.
So, who's the someone?
Nobody besides Monokuma would write such a dumb, threatening letter like that.
Wasn't me!
Are you sure?
The only lies I tell are friendly lies!
Friendly lies.
Those are still lies!
Doesn't matter who wrote it yet. So, Byakuya became paranoid because of this threatening letter?
He probably decided to throw a party because of the letter.
What do you mean?
By gathering everyone in one place, he tried to create a situation where everyone could keep tabs on each other. In doing so, he tried to put the writer of the letter in a situation where they couldn't act.
But the letter...
I don't know. See, he's becoming like... He's like on the fence. I can't think of anyone else.
As long as he was determined not to let any of us die, I couldn't take that risk. His strong sense of responsibility made him believe the letter was legitimate.
Ugh. You should have told us he received a threatening letter.
If he had, we would have panicked. Byakuya probably knew that too.
So, he tried to do something about it without telling anyone? See. Strong sense of responsibility.
Who was in the bathroom? The bathroom was locked. I believe there's a hole in there.
Screw that noise! Who the hell wrote that letter?
Well, obviously, the killer.
The killer. Is he really one of us? Who is it? Among us, who's the one who killed Byakuya?
Enough already! Show yourself, you coward!
I don't think it's him.
If they were willing to come forward, they never would have committed a murder in the first place.
She's suspicious. But I still can't believe it. Someone in this room killed Byakuya, and there's no way I can believe that yet.
Pardon me. Can I say something, please?
Yeah.
What is it, Miss Sonia?
I regret that I must return to this topic, but I just realized something concerning the night vision goggles.
Okay, let me know.
If Byakuya was indeed wearing those goggles, how did the killer manage to navigate in the dark?
Good question.
You're right.
Oh, the glowing paint.
He wouldn't have been able to see anything without the night vision goggles. But if the murderer had the goggles when they took the knife, then how did Byakuya see them?
Even if the knife bore some sort of mark, it would have been difficult to see it in that darkness.
But it's glow-in-the-dark paint. Now, the killer definitely used a mark, and because of this mark, the killer was able to get...
I see!
Gotta go for that glowing paint.
What if the glowing paint was the mark? With that, you'd be able to get the knife even in the dark. In actuality, the knife we found under the table and the duct tape stuck to the underside of the table were both marked with glowing paint. Right?
Does that mean the killer painted them in advance?
Hey Nagato, who was there in advance?
But painting them with glowing paint? It's as if they knew the blackout was going to happen.
They had to have already known. That's why they used the glowing paint as a mark.
Mm-hmm.
Which means whoever set up the blackout is the killer.
And who was there beforehand?
That seals it. The killer is whoever was in the office with the circuit breaker.
But Pekko was gone.
It was you! Pekko-Pekko-Yama!
No.
Pekko killed poor Byakuya? Was this island not big enough for two glasses wearers?
Not the killer.
I don't... Yeah, she's not.
Oh, I guess she's not.
How can you believe her so easily?
With Pekko's height, I don't think she'd be able to reach...
She has a sword.
I don't care about a technicality like that. Pekko's the one who tripped the breaker and caused the blackout.
This guy's blaming a lot. Pekko... Is that really what happened? No. After this debate, blue-colored weak spots will start to appearing. If we call these weak spots you've seen up until now argue spots, then the blue-colored weak spots will be called agree spots. When shooting agree spots with your truth bullets, you'll need to flip your way of thinking. Instead of arguing against that person's testimony, which contains lies or mistakes, fire the truth bullet to prove that the person's testimony is correct. When you fire your truth bullets, it'll merge with their... When your truth bullets merge with their weakness, it'll become a logically sound agreement. I'm a little hot in here. From now on, you must infer whether it's best to argue or agree based on what's being debated. If you press the escape, they're going to kill me. Good luck and have fun. I think this episode's going on a little long, so I think we finish the class trial in the next episode. Because I don't want it to last too long. But I think what I'll do is I'll post these two videos together, so people that don't have time to watch this whole thing cannot watch it, and people that have time can just go on to the next episode because I'll post it in the same day. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. This has been Tubaplyr NegativeAE. We will continue this class trial in the next episode.